वोल्टेज वी एस, वी एस इक्वल्स टू वॉट, डीएम साइन ओमेगा टी, एंड विच लोड वी कंसिडर, रेसिस्टिव लोड एंड द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस माई लोड आई कंसिडर इज वी नॉट द लोड वोल्टेज. सर नो, सो नाउ वी नीड टू ऑब्जर्व द वे फॉर्म एंड वी नीड टू फाइंड द एवरेज एंड आर एम एस वैल्यू ऑफ दट आउटपुट वोल्टेज. सर नो, आई एम इंडिकेटिंग दैट सर. And then similarly indicate the load current also. The load current we are indicating is, so indicating with what? So I not right. And here the polarity also at the DC, right? Actually, at the output we are getting DC. This is plus and here minus. So here nothing new, only the thing is the connection. So that means from circuit to circuit, the connection is the only difference. Okay, now based on the connection, we need to analyze the circuit and we need to draw the waveforms. Right. Now, can you try to draw the waveforms for this single phase, full wave rectifier with resistive load? Can you try it? Yes or no? The same thing. So first we need to draw the supply voltage, right? Wait. Yes. First, we need to consider supply voltage. In general, how many cycles are supply voltage we are considering? Only two cycles, right? Yes. And then gate pulse we'll consider. So if you draw it, so parallelly draw it, don't, so no need to wait. Okay, no? So for my output waveforms. Whether you made a mistake, that is also not a problem. If you draw it correctly, that's okay. Have you made any mistake? Means we will analyze, okay, no? Where you did the mistake, right? First, I will draw the input waveform. So my input waveform, it is a sinusoidal. Yes or no? This is one cycle. Is it okay, right? Yes. And divide the intervals 0 to pi, right? These are the dotted lines, right? The same thing we are doing. So, but you need to analyze. And make these as a dotted lines. All of you copy it into your notebook. So don't think that so I understood the waveform, so I don't want to draw the waveforms in my notebook. It's not like that. So even though you understood, but if you draw the waveforms once, then you will be much confident about drawing the waveforms in the exam. So keep in mind, so most of the time in the exam, the questions will be based on the converters and their waveforms and derivations. Derivations means, so average values and RMS, so that's it. From that average and RMS value, we can find out what power factor, and we can find out what powers also. Yes or no? So after this, indicate the dotted lines for gates, gate pulses also. So during positive half cycle, so we are applying the gate pulse to thyristors T1 and T2. And during nadir cycle, we are applying the gate pulse to what? T3 and T4. So at this position, I'm giving the gate pulse. This is the positive cycle, right? So positive cycle means we need to apply the gate pulse to T1 and T2, and this is the nadir cycle means T3 and T4. Okay, na? So, and again, so which type of load we consider? A resistive load I consider. Okay, na? There is no concept of energy storing. Yes or no? Now, so once the thyristor T1 and T2 are turned on, okay, now what is the direction of the current through the load? It is in downward direction or upward direction? All of you analyze meanwhile. So once the thyristors T1 and T2 turn on, what is the direction of current passing through the load? And similarly, during nadir cycle, T3 and T4 are turned on, right? And in that situation, what is the direction of the current through the load we need to observe? Okay, based on the current, we can find out the load voltage or load voltage drop. And if you apply the KVL, then we will get the relation between my output voltage V0 and VS. So all of you analyze meanwhile these two things. Okay, now so when thyristor T1 and T2 turn on, what is the direction of the load current? Is it in downward direction or upward direction? Across the load resistance R. All of you respond, all of you analyze. What is the direction of the current? It is in downward or upward direction. When thyristor T1 and T2 turn on. Yes, I can show good mark. Everyone, so everyone analyze. Yeah? Are you sleepy? Okay, now in view of that, I took the class at 2:30 actually. I plan to take the class at 2, but you have a OE class from 12 to 1, right? After that, half an hour time you will take for a lunch and 1 hour time for the rest. Yes, good Keshav. So it is in downward direction. All of you have there. I will tell you also, no problem for me. So once in the thyristor step during positive half cycle, okay? No? So the analysis will be like this. Even in the exam also, if you want to write a theory, actually, so no one will consider the theory, but keep in mind, but you need to write some theory points. So like this, during positive half cycle. Okay, now, so during positive half cycle means what is the polarity here? Plus. What is the polarity here? Minus. Okay, now, the plus terminal. Okay, now, the positive is connected to the anode of thyristor T1. You can write like this points, key points also. And similarly, the same positive, it is also connected to what? Cathode of thyristor T4. Okay, now, if positive is connected to anode, thyristor T1, it is in forward bias. Yes or no? And my thyristor T4, it is in what? Reverse bias. Is it okay for everyone? Understood now? And similarly, observe this terminal, if you observe this terminal. So this negative terminal connected to this branch now. This negative is connected to anode of thyristor T3 and cathode of thyristor T2. If negative is connected to anode, it will be in forward or reverse bias. It is in reverse bias. Then what about this one? Here the negative is connected to cathode, na? So the thyristor T2, it is in forward bias. Okay, na? Now, so now for suppose if you provide the gate signals to all four thyristors, okay, na? So if you provide the gate signal to all four thyristors, then which two thyristors will turn on? T1 or T2 or T3 or T4? I want response from every student. If you provide the gate pulse in this situation to all four thyristors, so which two thyristors will turn on? Is it T1 and T2 or T3 or T4? So which two thyristors will turn on if you provide the gate signal? So in this situation, I want response from every student. Please respond. If you're not responding, means simply I will. I thought that you were not listening. Okay, na? Even though it is a simple question, but I need response from all the students. That's good. So Aditya and Vignesh, Nikhil, right? So because this T1 and T2, they are in forward bias. Okay, na? The remaining T3 and T4. They are in reverse bias. Even if you provide the gate signal, so T3 and T4 doesn't turn on. Keep in mind. So at this position, we will give the gate pulse to thyristor T1 and thyristor T2. Then this thyristor T1, it will act like a closure circuit or a closure switch. And similarly, observe here. So this. So thyristor T2 also acts like a closure. Now, if you observe the current direction, okay, so the current now from the source, it is from positive, now always this is my current direction to 3 T1 at this position all of everywhere. So is there any path here? The T2 is open circuit or closed circuit? This one, it is open circuit, right? So directly this current is passing through the load in downward direction. Again, this current is coming like this. At this T2, the current will enter because here there is no path here because the T4 is open circuit, na? It will act like a open switch. So now the current is passing through the thyristor T2 and enters at the negative terminal and it completes the closure path. So now this is my current direction. That means if you observe the load current direction, it is in downward direction. If it is in downward direction, what is the polarity here? Plus, what is the polarity here? Minus. Now, if you apply the KVL in this loop itself, okay, na? Only we are having resistance and supply. So the supply means -2+. -2+ means if you take it as positive, Vs. Now, is there any other elements? I consider the voltage drop across the thyristors as 0. Directly comes to the load. What is the polarity? Plus minus means -V0. Is there any other elements? No. That is equals to 0. So my output voltage, so when thyristor T1 and T2 turn on, V0, that is equals to what? Vs only. Simply, my output voltage, it is equals to supply voltage when thyristor T1 and T2 turn on. Is it okay for everyone? Understood or not? But if you observe the thyristor T1 and T2, so in this cycle, positive cycle, for suppose if you are giving the pulse at alpha, so T1 and T2 will turn on from where to where? Definitely. So the thyristor T1 and T2, they are in on condition from where to where? From alpha to up to what? I want response. Alpha to up to? Yes, good, Nikhil. So alpha to pi only. Yes or no? Because after pi, after pi, the supply goes into the negative direction. Yes or no? So supply, when supply goes into the negative direction, so what happens now? That means during negative half cycle, the same thing we need to analyze. During negative half cycle, what is the polarity here? Here the polarity is minus. What is the polarity here? Here the polarity is plus. Now again, same analyze in the same way. This negative is connected to anode of thyristor T1. And similarly, this negative is connected to what? Cathode of thyristor T4. Okay, now. So the method means, so now which thyristor will turn on? Which thyristor is in forward bias? The thyristor T4 it is in forward bias. Yes or no? What about thyristor T1? Because the negative is connected to anode now. Now thyristor T1, it is in reverse bias. And similarly, positive. The positive is connected to where? Cathode of thyristor T2 and anode of thyristor T3. That means the thyristor T3, it is in forward bias. And my thyristor T2, it is in reverse bias condition. Condition, right? Again the same. Now again, if you provide the gate pulses to all four thyristors, which two thyristors will turn on? Definitely only T3 and T4 will turn on. What is the current direction? The current will comes out from where? Positive only. Yes or no? So this is my current direction here. From this point start. So the current ends here. Okay, no? But among T3 and T4, which is in on condition? T3 no. So the current is passing through T3 again. It is passing through what? So my load in this direction. Okay, no? Again observe. Again comes down. Okay, no? Again T4 is in forward bias now. T4, it is in turn off, and the current is entering it where? Negative. This is my closed loop. Now again, what is the current direction? Again, it is downward direction. Again, what is the polarity of the voltage? If the current is in downward direction, means what is the polarity here? Plus. What is the polarity here? Minus. Again, if you apply the KVL, you will get the same equation. That is Vs minus V0. That is equals to zero. Again, the output voltage, this is V0. It is equals to Vs. Okay, no? But the V0 value, observe. So the V0 value, so it is in the same direction. Again, plus minus. Okay, no? During positive cycle also. Plus minus for during negative cycle also plus minus. That means the output voltage doesn't change in its polarity during negative cycle also. I will draw the rough diagram first, then we will draw the complete diagram. For suppose here, if you consider my output voltage wave, okay, now so from where the output voltage starts? From alpha. Okay, now so during a positive cycle, which two thyristors will turn on here? The thyristor T1 and thyristor T2. Yes or no? After pi. So after pi, what happens? The thyristor T1 and T2 will turn off because it is a resistive load now. If it is an inductive load, so that means the inductor will support the conduction further also. But here it is a resistive load. So immediately at pi itself, the thyristor T1 and T2 will turn off again after pi plus alpha. Again at pi plus alpha, we are giving the gate pulse to what? T3 and T4 now. Again, so we are getting output voltage from pi plus alpha to 2 pi. Here, which thyristor will turn on? T3 and T4. Is it okay? Again, at 2 pi, these two thyristors again will turn off. Again, so after 2 pi plus alpha, again we are giving the gate pulse to thyristors T1 and T2. This is how my output voltage waveform. So once if you know the output voltage waveform, is it easy to draw the current waveform, right? Yes or no? Because it is a residual load simply. So residual load means what is the expression of the current simply? I naught equals to simply A naught equals to what? So V naught by R. This is my output voltage now. This is my output voltage waveform. If it is divided by the resistance, that means the peak value. This is the maximum value now for output voltage. If you consider the current maximum value, that is less than the maximum value of voltage, less than the maximum value of output voltage, because this maximum value Vm equals to what? Here Im equals to, this is Vm by R. Okay, now if this peak value is Vm, then what about the Im value? So the Im value equals to Vm by R. Similarly here also, when thyristor T1 and T2 off means there is no current. Again, when thyristor T3 and T4 off means there is no current. This is how the waveforms we are getting. So we are having the waveform from where to where? Only from alpha to pi. Yes or no? Again from where to where? Again from pi plus alpha to 2 pi. Now if you observe these waveforms, these waveforms are looking like a single phase full wave midpoint. Midpoint rectifier with residual load. Yes or no? Can you analyze, all of you? All of you refer single phase full wave midpoint rectifier with which load? R load. Are we getting the same waveforms or not? All of you verify. In case of single phase, full wave, midpoint rectifier with R load, the waveforms also the same, yes or no? We got the waveforms from where to where? Only alpha to pi. Now, anyone, what is the average value, V naught value? What is the average value? We have derived now for that type of waveform. If the waveform is existing from where to where, alpha to pi, then what is the average value? V naught equals to, be remembered, Vm by pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Yes or no? So Vm by pi, 1 plus cos alpha. Now, can I draw the waveforms? If you're having any doubt, please respond. If anyone facing any problem or any difficulty, so for the analyzing of or analysis of output voltage waveforms, you can respond or you can ask in the chat box or by unmuting yourself. First, I will indicate the gate pulses. Okay, now? Then what? Once we indicate the gate pulses, then I can draw the output voltage waveform. I don't want to derive here. I can do it, everyone. The same derivation. I can do it. My output voltage waveform, it is there from where to where? It is there from alpha to pi, right? Yes or no? It is there from alpha to pi. So limit. Okay, nah? Can you draw the output voltage waveform, right? The output voltage waveform start from where? Alpha, right? First, I will indicate these lines because these are all straight lines, right? So then I will draw the output. So this output voltage, keep in mind, here also it is follows the input wave. Exactly. That means the peak value of this output voltage and the peak value of input waveform, both will be same. That is the meaning. Okay, now? So once you draw the waveform, find out the average. So this is my output voltage waveform. So V naught. And similarly, draw the current waveform also. That's it. Again, when it comes to current waveform, also same. No? The current for waveform also follows the output voltage waveform because it is a still on. The only difference here is the peak value. The current waveform is having a less peak value. Now please, if anyone unable to understood, please respond. All of I can do the derivation for average value and RMS values of output voltage. Okay, na? This is my output voltage V naught, and this is the output current I naught. The same thing, omega t here. It is varying in terms of radians. So that is what omega t means. So and then I will indicate. This is my gate current IC, 8 pulse, and this is my supply voltage what VS. And then I will indicate. So angles. What is the angle here? This is alpha. What about here? This is pi. And this is pi plus alpha. Here also will indicate, no problem. Because I should know the waveform where it exists now. So my waveform, it is there from where to where. So only alpha to. Now can I directly write the V naught value, average value? Yes, sir, it is similar to single phase, full wave, midpoint rectifier now. Waveform. V naught equals to, what is the expression we remembered? So Vm by pi, yes or no? So Vm by pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Similarly, what about RMS value? Can anyone unmute yourself? Can you speak? What is the RMS value of single phase full wave midpoint rectifier? So what is the RMS value? So Vm by pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Okay. So this is the average. I don't want to derive again because the derivation is same here, right? My waveform, it is there from where to where? Alpha to pi. And what is the time period? Anyone, what is RMS value? Can anyone remember? So V naught R equals to Vm by
root pi.
Yes, root pi.
Under root of pi minus alpha.
Under root of pi minus alpha.
Plus sine 2 alpha by 2.
Forget to tell 2 also there now. Vm by 2 root 2 pi, right? My Vm by root pi or root 2 pi?
Root 2 pi,
Vm
sir.
Vm by root 2 pi, sir.
Yes. So 2 is there. So Vm by root 2 pi. Again under root pi minus alpha. Plus 1 by 2 sine 2 alpha. Right. So root 2 pi I will mention. But in the exam you need to derive, keep in mind. But in the exam, so if you ask to explain about single phase full wave rectifier with R load, bridge connection means definitely so you need to derive all these things, these two expressions. So under root. But those who completed these two derivations, can you try to draw the connection diagram for RE load? RE load. So here you will consider resistance and back EMF or battery voltage, no? Can you draw it and analyze the same thing? So here pi minus so this is pi. I think from the third year, so many students applied for the gate, right? Especially from third year, A sections I have read that so many students applied for the gate. That is a good sign. So third year is the best time to prepare for the gate. Keep in mind, even in fourth year also not possible. Almost all the subjects, which are the subject you study in this third year, so those subjects will be covered in your gate syllabus. If you consider this power electronics and machines, so 1 by 2 sine 2 alpha, right? That's it. So these are the expressions for my so average values and so RMS values of full wave. So Bedge rectifier with rest. Many doubts? If you're having any doubt, please respond. I'm very happy to so answer your doubts. Any doubt, single doubt. So in my BTEC, in every class, in every subject, when the faculty says any doubts, means definitely I will ask one or two doubts. That's how I am. Any doubts regarding to this full wave rectifier with R load? Any doubts? No. So I forgot to mention thyristors also, right? Here, even, comma. Wait. E3, E4, right? So during NADU, so NADU circle, so T3, D4 and here T1, D2. The same thing here. Is there any doubts? No? Any doubts? At least understood or not? Respond for that. For not having a doubt, that's not a problem. But if you not understood, there's a problem. Right. Okay, all of you completed single phase full rectifier with R load, average value, and so the RMS value. So only 4 members understood. So what about remaining students? Yes. So and then keep adding as single phase, full wave. Okay now. So rectifier, it's a bridge rectifier, even with which load? So RE load. Yes or no? So first of all, if you draw the connection diagram. So meanwhile, I will get charge for my laptop. So I'll have to draw the connection diagram first. And then so and then try to draw the waveforms, that's it. So, but on that board, I think won't take this much time. So, because it's a whiteboard now, so it will take a little bit more time. So, even though I'm taking more time, so I'm very happy about the connection diagrams and waveforms. They are looking good, right? So, in Blackboard, they doesn't look like this. Right. First, draw the connection diagram. Same. Four thyristors. They are connected. In bridge connection. And they are. This is T1. This is my thyristor T1. And this is T2. Now, gate. And similarly, consider T3, T4. This is my thyristor T3. This is T4. Okay, right, is there any difficulty? So this is the advantage of this subject. So you don't need to prepare the subject also. So once if you understood how I'm analyzing now, so it doesn't require preparation, keep in mind, for this subject. So once if you understood, so then I will consider the load. Which load we need to consider? Resistance and battery. So RE load. Okay. This is my resistance R. So, and then include the input. So, VS. Right. Can anyone draw the waveforms? If anyone completed, please respond my waveforms for this load. Keep in mind, in the GATE exam, they will give different loads. He can give only L load also, only C load also, only E load also. Okay, so only R load also. That is the reason why I consider this RE load also. Actually, I don't want to consider this RE load. For better analysis, I consider RE load. Anyone completed the waveform? If completed, the same thing. So find out its average value and then RMS value. Yes or no? Give the numberings. This is T3, right? This is T4. What about this one? T1, T2, and this is yes. The output voltage is V0. This is across combination of resistance and a battery voltage in generally, or a back EMF as you can consider. Okay, no? This is V0. Okay, so and then the current, so I0, actually after the operation only we can indicate the current, but I'm indicating now. So can anyone, so but in the load, if there is a battery, that is back EMF or EMF, so if there is a EMF in the load, so which thing we need to consider first? All of F3. First of us consider the positive cycle itself. Consider the positive cycle itself. I think we are already familiar with the analysis of RLE, right? Yes or no? If we consider the positive cycle itself. So during positive cycle, definitely, so there is a T1. And then what? The thyristor T2, they will be in forward bias condition. When means here we are having what? The back EMF or battery, right? Because of this back EMF or battery, okay now, so even though we are having a positive voltage, the thyristor T1 and T2, they are not in forward bias. So when they will be in forward bias? If the voltage across this T1 and T2, if it is more than, observe, that means if it is more than Vs minus E now, the same thing we observed, right? At the time of RLE load, do you remember? This Vs minus E, if this value equals to what? Positive. Yes or no? That Vs minus E, if that value equals to positive, then only, so my thyristor T1 and T2, they are in what? forward bias. Yes or no? First of all, this Vs minus E value is negative. What is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of that? The thrust T1 and T2, they are in reverse bias. They are not in forward bias. For that purpose, do you remember or not? In the output waveform for RLE load, or at the time of RLE load, we indicated a line like this, right? And we consider this angle as what? Theta 1. They remembered. And this angle is what? Theta 2. What is the meaning of this theta 1 and theta 2? What is the meaning of that theta 1 and theta 2? So if the triggering pulse or gate pulse, if it is given before theta 1, okay, now before theta 1 means the thyristor T1 and T2, they doesn't turn on. Yes or no? So that means the triggering pulse has to be given after theta 1 only. Even if you provide the gate pulse or firing pulse before theta 1, so my thyristors T1 and T2 doesn't turn on. Yes or no? That means if you draw rough, so I will draw rough waveforms first. Then you will write. Okay, now? So first of all, consider the input waveform. So like this. Okay, now? So when it comes to output, first of all, consider this is theta. And this is corresponding to what? Theta. And this is my battery MFE. Okay, now? First, suppose I'm giving the pulse at theta 1 itself. Okay, now? I'm giving the gate pulse at theta 1 itself. First, suppose consider my alpha value is theta 1 itself. What happened? The thyristor T1 and T2 will turn on at what? At theta 1 position itself, right? Yes or no? So from theta 1 itself, the thyristor T1 and T2 turn on. Then we are getting what? The output voltage, no? The output voltage V0 equals what? Then Vs only. From theta 1 to up to where? Again, up to theta 2 only. After theta 2, what happens now? Again, after theta 2, again, what happens? This Vs minus E value. This is Vs, right? So Vs is less than E, so Vs is less than E means Vs minus E, it will becomes a negative value. So my thyristor T1 and T2 will turn off at what condition or at what situation? At theta 2 itself, the thyristor T2 and T1 will turn off. Then what is the output voltage? T1 and T2 turn off means what is output voltage? So then current equals I0 equals what? T1 and T2 turn off means I0 equals 0. There is no current, right? If I0 equals 0, what is the output voltage V0 value? I'll tell you always the output voltage, if current I0 equals 0, it is equals to E only. E is there now. Yes, good, Shivani. So the back EMF or battery voltage E is there always. So then, so simply V0 equals to E when up to, again, so for this waveform also. Okay, now. For this bottom waveform also, for the during negative cycle also, observe. During negative cycle also, we can find out this theta 1 angles. Again, during negative cycle also, which thyristors will turn on? T3 and T4. Again, the same thing, keep in mind. Again, the same thing. So T3 and T4 will turn on if the applied voltage, negative voltage, this is the negative voltage. But with respect to T3 and T4, that is a positive voltage now. Yes or no? With respect to T3 and T4, that is a positive voltage. Yes or no? Again, the same thing here. After this angle, my thyristor T3 and T4 will turn on. Then again I'm getting what? A positive voltage in the load. Again, when T1 and T2 turn off means the output voltage equals to what? Again, it is back in. So like this, we are getting a waveform. All of you understood. So when it comes to RE load, so my waveform, it is existing from where to where? From theta 1 to theta 2. If you give the gate pulse at theta 1 itself, first suppose, if we are giving the gate pulse at alpha, then so from where to where? Alpha to theta 2. Again, so what is the time period at this point? This is pi plus alpha. Up to where? Pi plus alpha 2. Again, this is a theta 2 norm. But so don't consider theta 2 again. So this is theta 2 means what is this angle total? to this position. That angle we need to consider. That means indirectly, so my waveform, it is there from only alpha to theta to only, not up to pi or not up to beta. Here the beta value, keep in mind, so when it comes to RE load, RE load, the beta value that is equals to theta to only. So why means? Because there is no L load. Yes or no? After theta 2, the difference between Vs minus E, this difference becomes what? N negative value. So indirectly, what is the meaning of that? So negative value means the voltage across the thyristors becomes negative. Then the thyristors will turn off. Is it okay? Understood, right? This is how we are getting. When it comes to RE load, we are having waveform only from alpha to theta 2. And if you want to derive the derivation also, to find out average value, we need to consider the limits from where to where. My waveform is there from where to where? It is there from, if you consider alpha to theta. If you consider alpha itself as a theta means, theta 1 means, theta 1 to theta 2, I am having my output waveform. And similarly, when it comes to current waveform, how to draw the current waveform? When thyristors turn on, then only we are having current, right? Yes or no? So this is my current waveform from theta 1 to theta 2. Again, so like this we are getting current wave. Yes or no? All of you understood? Can you draw it now? Can you draw the output voltage waveform first? Do it just hardly, it will take 2 minutes of time. First to draw the input waveform, so then draw the gate pulses, then indicate what output voltage waveform is existing from where to where. If we consider alpha equals to theta 1 means from theta 1 to theta 2, it is there. That is the only observation in case of RE load. Not only in case of full wave bridge rectifier, in case of midpoint rectifier also. Keep in mind. So if you consider a RE load, okay, no? In case of RE load, we are having the output voltage waveform from alpha to theta 2 only, not up to pi or not up to beta. Can you draw the waveform? Okay, now do it. First, draw the input waveform, everyone. So only one load is left, that is RLE load. Okay, now. So we will take one more class. In that class, I will complete that RLE load and we will solve some problems. So with that, I will close the second unit. In the next week, I will start the third unit. In the third unit, also the same thing. Instead of single phase, we will consider what? Three phase. Here we consider a single phase supply now. So we will consider three phase. Sunil, I'm not taking attendance, man. Huh? I think you are not listening. You are listening or not? Sunil. So here also consider two cycles. So again divide the interval. It will take 5 minutes, that's it. Zero to pi. So pi to 2 pi. 2 pi to 3 pi. 3/4. Right. So I will make them as a dotted lines. So after that, indicate the gate pulse. So consider the gate pulse are given at alpha and my output waveform, output voltage waveform, it is there from where to where? It is there from where to where? Yes, good, sir. So alpha to theta to. So if you draw the waveform, all if you try to find out average value, can anyone try? Consider the limits from alpha to theta to. And what is the time period? What is the time period? Keep in mind, so when it comes single phase full wave, the time period is pi only. In case of half wave, we got the time period as 2 pi. In case of full wave, we have the time period as pi only. Why we have the time period as pi means, already at the starting itself, for one pulse, for one cycle of input, how many pulses we are getting? Two pulses now. That means within one cycle of input, we are completing two pulses. That is the reason why, in case of full wave, the time period, it is equal to pi. Is can anyone try to find out average value V0 for the output waveform? There is some other color for gate pulses. So we'll use this color. And we need to provide the gate signal when? After theta 1 only. Yes or no? After theta 1 only. So we need to provide the gate. Again, these are also dotted lines, keep in mind. Then indicate the gate pulse. So once if you indicate the gate pulse, then try to draw the output voltage wave. Okay, now. So when thyristors, so two thyristors are in off condition means, what is the output voltage? I want response from every student. When thyristors are in off condition means, what is the output voltage? V0 value. So only two members responded. So when, so thyristors are not on condition means what? So my output voltage is simply, that is equals to back EMF or battery voltage E. Yes or no? That is not depends on the current, right? But the load current is depends on thyristors, whether turn on or turn off. But when it comes to back EMF E, that is not depends on my load current. The load current is zero, simply my the load voltage V0 equals to E. Okay, now. So now we indicate the gate pulse. I will use thick gate pulse. So here I am giving the gate pulse. Okay, now. It's like a square pulse, keep in mind. So square pulse means it is a square waveform. In signals and systems subject, we are having types of waveforms, square, ramp. I think in control systems also studied now. Right? First, I will indicate the back EMF, which color we will use. We will use this color. So during this period, observe here, thyristors are in off condition or off, on condition, off right, and thyristors off means the output voltage V0 equals to what? E. Again, in this, so in this interval also, my output voltage equals to E. In this interval also, my output voltage equals to E. In this interval also, my output voltage equals to E. And that means during this time interval, no thyristor is in conduction. Okay, now that is a very, very important observation. again from this point alpha 2 theta 2. Is it theta 2? Forget to mention theta 2. Right. Now for theta 2, I will draw one more line. Consider this is a theta 2 line. Okay, now. This black line. So now my EMF E value is there up to what? Up to theta 2 now. Sir, no. Here I forget to draw one more line. Okay. Well, if you understood. This is how. So now I will draw the output voltage waveform from alpha 2 from alpha to where? Up to theta 2 only we have the waveform. Okay, that's okay. This is how the output voltage waveform. Then what about current waveform? Observe here. The current means less than the peak value, definitely. It is also there from alpha 2, theta 2 only. It's a dotted line, Vignesh. I will make it as a dotted line. They are not thick lines. So all these are the dotted lines. Okay, now this black line is a dotted line. This is how the current waveform. It's a discontinuous, it is not a continuous current waveform. In the gate exam, how the questions we are getting for oral reference means, simply you will give the current waveform, okay, now, and you will ask to find out the current values, so like that. It is better to remember some standard waveforms average values instead of doing derivation in the exam. Okay, now I will make that black line as a dotted line. So this is how we got the, so output voltage and current waveform. Can you try to find out average value? So V naught. So the V naught means average value for my output voltage. And output voltage waveform, it is there from where to where? Only alpha to theta 2. Okay, so indicate, so this is the gate current pulse and this is what output voltage waveform, output current waveform. This is V naught. This is I naught. This is IC. Okay. And this is as usual VS, my supply voltage. Is it okay for everyone? Understood now? And indicate the angles also. So what is the angle here? This is alpha. This is theta 2, right? Again here also. This is alpha. This is theta 2. Okay now? Actually, we need to indicate the back EMF also here, right? That is E value. I will indicate like this up here. Those back lines, so that means. Actually, why I'm not indicating means. So, for positive pulse, this is how the EMF looks like now. For negative pulses up there, for negative pulse also. The EMF, it will be look like this. Keep in mind. For thyristor T1 and T3. It looks like opposite now. For T1 and T3, it looks like, so in this direction now. For T3 and T4, it looks like opposite. That is the reason why I'm not indicating there. But just keep in mind. So here, this value is E. This value is capital E. So that means my waveform, it is existing from where to where only, alpha to theta 2 only. In the remaining time periods, the output voltage V naught equals simply, so E only. And indicate the thyristors also, no problem. So during this interval, so which thyristor will turn on? E1 and T2. I will indicate vertically. So here E3, some so during this time interval T3 T4 will turn on. During this time interval T1 and T2 will turn on. Is it okay for everyone? Understood, ma? If you're having any doubt, please respond in the chat box. Any doubt? I'm very happy to respond to your doubts. So here again, E3. I think on the blackboard, it is not possible to indicate these many colors, right? Completed everyone? Yes, Nikita, what is that, ma? Completed or not? Please respond. Yes. If you're having any doubt, please respond, ma. Regarding to R load and RE load. And the next class, we will see RLE load. Okay, now? So we'll see RLE load. So with this, I'm closing the session. If you're having any doubts, so please respond in the chat box. Or else just respond your attendance in the chat box. Respond your attendance. And if you're not having any doubt, please respond to your attendance and we can leave the session. Okay, now? Can I take one more class tomorrow? With that, I will complete full wave rectifier with RLE load also. Can I take one more class? Tomorrow at the same time. If it is okay for you, I will take. So, or else, no. Okay, completed everyone, right? Yes.